happens to be a single penny left for me. That's too bad. In my dreams, I have a plan. If I got me a wealthy man, I wouldn't have to work at all. I'd fool around and have a ball.
Immediately, please. 15 minutes? Fantastic. Make it 10 if you can. Perkins, 42 Elgam. Yes, yes, that's right. It's on the corner. Thank you.
Henry.
Jean, listen.
No, Lou, listen. You've been drinking and it's affected your brain. You're not used to alcohol and you've gone funny.
No, I haven't gone funny.
Yes, you have. I'm not sure what's happened to you exactly. We're not travelling to Barcelona tonight. We've got Vic and Betty coming round at 6:30. I've been working you fine.
quite damp. What's that?
1,135,000 pounds!
What is it?
Cash!
What is it?
Money! Cash! 1,135,000 pounds! All in 50s! 22,750 pound notes! 1,135,000 pounds! All in used notes!
What is it, Henry?
It's a bloody fortune, Jean! Passports!
Henry, how did all this money get in your briefcase?
That's just it. It's not my briefcase.
What are you talking about?
Well, I got off the underground train at Fulham Broadway, you know, the way I always do with my briefcase, and started to walk home. You know, the way I always do down Elmer Road. Have you moved our passports?
Oh, they're in the cupboard. Get on with it.
Well, it was getting a bit nippy, so I thought I'd put on my gloves and scarf. Now, they were in my briefcase, so I stopped, flipped open my briefcase. Only it wasn't my briefcase!
Not your briefcase?
Ah, passports.
What do you mean, not your briefcase?
Well, I must have left mine on the train and taken this one by mistake, or else somebody took mine and left theirs.
Why didn't you take it back right away?
I was in shock. How would you like it if you opened your handbag to part of your nose and you found 1,135,000 pounds in it?
How do you know the exact amount?
I counted.
You counted it in the middle of Alma Road?
No, in the Prince of Wales Park.
I knew you'd been drinking.
Well, I had to pull myself together. I had to think what to do.
Taken it to the London Transport Lost Property Office. That's what you should have done.
So I ordered a large whiskey and went into the gents' loo.
The loo?
To check if I hadn't been seeing things. And I hadn't. I sat in the lavatory seat and counted it all out. Then I went back into the bar and had that double whiskey. Then I had another whiskey, went back into the gents, sat in the loo again, and counted it all over again.
Come on, you're an hour late.
Actually, I had one more double whiskey and another sit in the loo before I was finished. I just couldn't believe it.
Henry.
Jean, we'll never get another chance like this as long as we live. We've got to grab it with both hands.
Can't you suddenly leave at a moment's notice?
Oh, yes, we can. Oh, we're travelling first class. I'll take a couple of these for tips on the flight.
Henry.
It is now. Go and pack.
Henry, it's stealing.
Oh, no, it's not. I gave that a lot of thought when I was sitting on the Prince of Wales loo. It seems to me this money is ill-gotten gains. I mean, it must be, right? Used notes all wrapped up in elastic bands. It'll be a payment to a Mr. Nasty for some illicit transaction. This cash won't show in anyone's books. It won't reflect in anyone's accounts. No income tax or VAT would be paid on it. This money doesn't exist. And if it doesn't exist, I can't have stolen it.
Henry.
Jean, my conscience is clear. I have worked very hard for nothing for 30 years. And at long last, I have received my bonus.
But the police.
The police will never get involved because the loss of this cash will never be reported to the police. Now go and pack that suitcase.
Henry.
And just a sponge bag and a couple of pairs of underpants for me.
Henry, I want to have dinner with Mick and Betty. I want to have our roast chicken, and I want to stay here at 42 Elder Avenue.
Jean, you don't understand. We can't stay here. I've burnt my bridges. I can't go back to the office.
It's not too late.
Yes, it is. If I've got Mr. Nasty's briefcase, he's got mine. It's got my office stuff in it. Tomorrow morning, he'll call at the office looking for his briefcase, and me. By that time, we have to be 1,000 miles away, booked into some Spanish hotel as a Mr. and Mrs. Shufflebottom.
Henry, he'll come looking for us. What matter if we're
he won't know where to find us.
He'll report us to the police. They'll find us. Interpol. It'll be awful.
It'll be lovely because there won't be any Interpol. I told you, Mr. Nasty cannot go to the police because Mr. Nasty has fiddled 1,135,000 pounds. And now the fiddler has become well and truly fiddled by yours truly, Henry A. Perkins.
Henry.
Because I've never felt this way, that's why.
I liked you as you were. A bit of a wimp.
Well, those days are over. We're both going to sunny Spain. Viva España!
I don't like Barcelona, Henry.
It'd be daft. You're lovely in Spain. We've had three holidays there.
Holidays, yes. We weren't emigrating.
All right, if you don't like Barcelona, we'll just stay overnight and then fly on somewhere else tomorrow. Australia, Bermuda, Bali. We'll buy Bali!
Oh, Henry, I like it
family. We haven't got any family.
Alf and Doris.
Doris is your second cousin, and you haven't seen her for 20 years.
We'll send her a postcard at Christmas.
We'll send her one from Barcelona. Now go and pack that suitcase.
Oh, God.
That'll be the tactical, Vic and Betty. You get rid of them, and I'll pack the suitcase.
Well, what will I tell them?
Tell them to go to the Savoy and have dinner on me.
Oh. But it's your birthday, Henry. Oh. It's his birthday. Oh, I'm sorry I took so long. I was expecting someone else.
Detective Sergeant Davenport, madam. Fulham CID.
Fulham CID?
That's correct, madam. I was wondering if I might have a word with the gentleman of the house.
The gentleman?
That would be your husband, would it, madam?
Yes. What exactly? Could you tell me what the problem is?
I can't speak to your husband, Mrs.
Perkins.
Ah, Perkins.
Yes, he's upstairs at the moment. Would you like a peanut?
No, thank you.
I'll just see who's at Henry! That's my husband. Henry! Excuse me, Sergeant, I'll just see who's at the...
Of course.
I expect it'll be Vic and Betty. They're having dinner with us this evening. Henry! Do sit down. Henry! Yes, the Johnsons, Vic and Betty. Yes. Just the four of us. Henry and me, Vic and Betty. It's his birthday.
That's nice.
Henry's not Vic's. I don't know when Vic's is.
Well, you'd better let them in.
Oh, yes. Henry won't be. He's just getting dressed in his birthday suit. I don't think he's got no, he has.
No, of course.
Yes. Good evening, Mum.
Oh, I thought.
You thought 50 and I might eat him.
I beg your pardon?
Fulham taxis.
Oh, yes.
I'm Bill. Right, Israel Airport. How many cases?
Cases?
To go.
Yes, cases. For the airport. Somebody flying off. Yes, it's my sister. She's staying with us. She has been. She's leaving this evening for the airport.
No, it's Mr. Perkins.
What?
The docket says Mr. Perkins.
No, Mr. Perkins isn't going anywhere. It's his birthday. No, Mr. Perkins just made the booking. No, it's my sister who's leaving, flying off.
So, how many cases?
Oh, yes, I'm not sure. Bill, did you say it was?
Yes, Bill.
Why don't you wait in the taxi, Bill? Mr. Perkins will help with the suitcases. My sister's not quite ready yet.
Right, I'm parked round the corner. What's her destination?
Maybe
your sister, where is she flying off to?
Australia!
Australia, down under, eh?
Yes, she emigrated. She's been here for a visit. Now she's going back to Sydney.
Very nice. Well, I'm parked in that side street. Would you just give me a shout when the pair of them are ready?
A pair of them?
Yes, well, the docket says two people, madam. That's a pair.
Yes, that's right. Yes. And her husband. That's why she emigrated. He's Australian. I'll turn up your park round the corner.
That's right. Nice to have met you.
Oh, hectic in here tonight.
Certainly seems that way. Do you have something in the oven? Dinner with your friends, the Johnstons.
Oh, yes.
And you do seem a bit distracted.
No. Roast chicken, it's all in hand.
Oh, it's a pity your sister and her husband are going to miss it.
What? Oh, yes. Adelaide and Percy. Yes, they've got to catch their aeroplane.
Still, Sydney. By the time they finish that journey, they'll have had half a dozen dinners.
Yes.
Right, all packed.
Henry!
Did you deal with Vic and Betty?
Henry, we got a visitor.
A visitor? Ah, Fulham taxis.
Fulham police, actually.
Great. Police.
Detective Sergeant Davenport, CID.
Yes, that's fine. What seems to be the problem, Sergeant? Neighbours complaining about something?
You are Mr. Perkins, aren't you, sir? Mr. Henry Perkins?
The very same.
Oh, I wonder if I might have a word with you, sir.
Certainly. What about?
If your wife wouldn't mind, I'd prefer to speak to you alone.
Alone? Of course.
Although I'm quite prepared to wait until your wife's sister has gone.
My wife's...
He's referring to Adelaide.
Adelaide, they're about to leave, I gather.
When he says they,
Adelaide and Percy.
Down under there.
Adelaide, Percy and Sydney.
Yes, thanks for bringing their luggage down.
Oh, pleasure.
I really don't think the sergeant need wait for Adelaide and Percy to leave, do you, Henry?
Certainly not, nor Sydney. Police business first. Shall we go into the kitchen, Sergeant?
That'll be the taxi. Tell its wife.
Bill's here already.
Who's Bill?
Taxis.
Ah, great.
For Adelaide and Percy.
Ah, yes.
I expect it'll be Vicar Betty Johnson.
Just get rid of them.
Well, I tell them they've come for dinner.
Tell them to leave their presents and go.
I've decided to have the wife all to myself tonight. It's my birthday, isn't it? Not Vic's.
They'll understand. Tell them we're going to bed. After I've satisfied the sergeant, of course.
When I say after I've satisfied the sergeant, I meant after I've answered the sergeant's questions. After you, Sergeant.
Henry, I can't go.
Of course you can.
I can't.
You can.
She can. She just thinks she can't.
Oh,
perhaps it would be better, sir, if you answered the door and I'll wait for you in the kitchen.
Oh, that's a good idea.
Yes, all right. It shouldn't take a moment.
No. And after you've seen your friends off, perhaps your in-laws will have left as well.
What in-laws? Oh, yeah. Percy and Adelaide. Yes, they're upstairs all packed and ready to go.
Will you kindly make it a bit smartish, Mr. Perkins? I do have a line of inquiry to follow, you know.
Of course, Sergeant. But put the kettle on for a cuppa, would you?
Yes.
Henry, you said that man wouldn't go.
What man wouldn't go where?
The man who took your briefcase. What? You said he wouldn't report it to the police.
Well, the sergeant might not have called about the briefcase.
Of course it's about the briefcase. Why do you think he wants to see you alone?
Look, possession is 9/10 the law. No one can claim this isn't my savings.
£1,135,000.
I've been through.
Oh, God. I need a drink.
Jean, you don't drink.
I'm starting now.
You're a fine one to talk with Percy and Sydney on their way to Adelaide.
It's Adelaide and Percy on the way to Sydney.
Whatever.
Oh, Henry.
Get a grip on yourself, Jean. This is the happiest day of our lives.
I'm afraid dinner's off.
Oh, I've got to move it.
The clock's ticking on, you know.
Clock?
Taxi, on the meter.
Are you Ben?
I'm Bill.
Ah, yes.
And you're Mr. Perkins, are you?
Correct. Please take that suitcase.
What about that policeman?
I'll deal with it.
Policeman?
Never mind, just wait outside and you wait with him.
I'm not going. No,
yes, you are.
No, she isn't. Her sister's going.
I want her to see her sister off. Now take that case and go outside.
You leave that case where it is. Henry, you're not thinking straight.
Jean, stop drinking and do as you're told.
Here, why didn't you let her sister sort out her own suitcase?
Wait outside. What terminal is it?
What?
British Airways to Barcelona.
What's it got to do with her sister flying to Sydney?
How long will it take to get there?
Oh, about 24 hours, I imagine.
To get to Heathrow?
At this rate, about 24 hours.
Wait outside. And you go get your toothbrush.
I can't do it, Henry. You'll have to leave without me.
I'm doing no such thing. Now, come on.
I can't just up and leave like this. I'll be a nervous wreck. It's driven me to drink already.
How many more times? Tomorrow morning, Mr. Nasty is going to call at the office and get our address. Mr. Nasty will then come visiting 42 Elgar Avenue
And if he finds you still here, he's going to cut you up into very tiny little pieces and bury you in cement.
And we all thanks to you.
You silly woman.
Excuse me.
You silly, silly woman. Isn't she a silly woman for mixing her drinks like that?
I was wondering if you were ready to join me in the kitchen.
I am indeed after you, Sergeant.
They've gone then, have they?
Who's that?
Your wife's sister and her husband.
Oh, yes, yes. Mr. and Mrs.
Adelaide and Percy.
Yes, I know it's Adelaide and Percy. It's Percy's second name that keeps slipping my mind. Brown, yes, Percy Brown. What were you asking me, Sergeant?
I was asking if Mr. and Mrs. Brown had left for the airport. Not quite yet, no.
Oh, God.
You're a bundle of nerves. Jean, it's only Vic and Betty. You know what to tell him. You're giving me a surprise birthday present in bed.
Henry!
Look at her. I've never known her so jumpy. I hope that's not going to affect my birthday present in bed.
Sorry we're late, darling.
Oh, Betty!
I say we. That damn fool husband of mine is round the corner arguing.
Arguing?
We hit a taxi.
Taxi?
That was parked on that side street. Vic said he shouldn't have been parked right on the corner. Taxi driver's very upset.
Oh, that'll be Bill.
Well, Bill called Vic a pillock, and then Vic offered to alter the shape of Bill's nose.
Oh, Betty, it's terrible. Henry's in the kitchen with a policeman and he's got Bill.
Have we skipped a couple of episodes?
He wasn't.
Explanation of what, for goodness sake?
Of
my behaviour in the pub.
What's he talking about?
God only knows.
The sergeant was off duty having a drink in the pub.
The Prince of Wales?
Yes, and I was accused me.
Accused you of what?
Soliciting.
Soliciting?
Men.
What?
Let it chink, I'll go
and
sort them.
No, don't make it.
No.
How could he think you were soliciting men?
Well, according to the sergeant, I entered the Prince of Wales public house in a highly emotional condition. During the course of the next half hour, he observed me going to the bathroom 3 times. Each time I came out looking more and more excited. He noted that I continually glanced furtively around the saloon bar, licking my lips and perspiring profusely, my eyes getting progressively more manic. Apparently, I was also breathing heavily, my hands were shaking, and saliva was trickling down my chin.
So with his hands been shaking, he'd been doing what you've been doing in the loo.
Well, I wasn't going to tell him that, was I? He followed me from the pub.
What did you tell
him? I admitted it.
You did?
What?
I confessed.
You confessed to soliciting men?
I want to get to the airport.
You'll go as far as Wormwood Scrubs, you will.
No, I won't. £25,000, and he never saw a thing.
Henry, you can't bribe a police officer.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Well, I offered 10,000, he asked for 30, and we settled on 25,000.
What's all this about the airport?
It doesn't matter.
Need another drink?
Oh, I think we all do. Jean?
Yes, anything to kill the pain.
And I hope they're all right.
He's only been home 5 minutes and he's admitted soliciting men, bribed a police officer, and bought bloody barley.
And you're married to them. Devil.
If it's that bloody taxi driver again, I'll ring his neck.
For heaven's sake.
I can't move my taxi, you know that. You are a very silly, insignificant little man.
Vic, that's not a nice way to...
No, it's bloody rude, you Burke.
What do you mean, your taxi won't?
Well, this prat crammed my back bumper, didn't he? So now my back bumper is jammed up against my rear wheel, innit? And my taxi won't bloody budge, will it?
Would you believe it? He insists on counting it. Ah, Ben.
Bill.
Prepare to hit the track for Heathrow.
What about our dinner?
Vic.
I'm not hitting the track for nowhere. This prat has pranked my car.
Watch it, sunshine.
Vic.
Can't you get your taxi to start?
I can get it to start, but I can't get it to move.
We'll give you a hand to sort out your bumper.
Thanks, Betty.
My bloody world. He found the police about me.
The police?
No, I didn't, you pillock. I couldn't get through, so I thought forget it, you Burke.
Oh, there you are, then.
Well, that's more like it. I'll give you a hand to fix your bumper.
You see. He's quite a nice man, really.
No, I'm not. I'm a pillock. You better get your things to get their skates on.
Slight change of plan. The in-laws aren't going anymore.
Not going?
No, this is perfect for me.
She definitely said the in-laws.
Well, the outlaws are going instead. Right, no more ifs and buts. Get your things. Fate is shining down upon us today, my girl.
I can't get my thoughts sorted out.
Sort them out in the aeroplane and leave this stuff alone. And don't let this out of your sight.
Where are you going?
To see if the sergeant's finished counting his 25,000.
I can't believe you met a police officer.
Oh, I think he was leaving a bit before I started.
Oh. I preferred it when you were a bit of a wimp. Oh, God. Oh.
I'm sorry. Are you Mrs. Perkins?
Why?
May I come in, please?
Well, I was just... Are you selling something?
No, madam.
What can I do for you? It's a bit late to be calling, isn't it?
Detective Sergeant Slater.
Detective? Are you a policeman?
Putney CID.
Putney?
Yes, madam.
Not Fulham?
No. Perhaps you'd better sit down, Mrs. Perkins.
No, I think I'd rather stand... Is it to do with Mr. Perkins?
Yes, it is. Perhaps you'd better sit down.
Well, what exactly do you want to see my husband about?
It's you I've called to see, Mrs. Perkins.
Me?
Yes. I'm afraid I have some disturbing news for you.
Have you?
Yes. Probably wondering why husband isn't home.
Well, I was at first, yes.
We have reason to believe that Henry Perkins is dead.
Mr. Perkins is dead.
That's why I'm here. You'll be required to make a formal identification of the body.
No, listen. Mr. Perkins, my husband, I think there's been some mistake.
Would you like me to make you a cup of tea, Mrs. Perkins? Oh, where's the kitchen?
No. What makes you think Henry's dead?
2 bullet holes in the back of his head. And his body was thrown in the river at Putney Bridge. And also, his legs were tied together.
His legs?
And his arms.
His arms?
And there was weights attached to his ankles.
So it wasn't an accident then?
I'm so sorry, Mrs. Perkins. I'll make you that cup of tea.
No tea, thank you.
Something stronger, perhaps, under the circumstances. Do you drink?
Yes, very heavily. Help yourself.
I'm on duty, Mrs. Perkins.
What precisely makes you think the dead body is my Henry?
Well, although he had no formal identification about his person, he was still clutching his briefcase.
His briefcase?
Is this your husband's briefcase, Mrs. Perkins?
Oh, yes, it looks like it. It's all wet.
It's been in the river. Are these Mr. Perkins' effects?
Yes, they would appear to be, yes.
Your husband worked as an accountant at the firm of Bodley, Bodley and Crouch, is that so?
Yes, in the city.
64 Fenchurch Street.
Yes.
And there was a cell phone.
Yes, that's Henry's.
And various papers, office memos, that kind of thing, with his full name on it. Henry A. Perkins. Is that your husband's full name?
Henry A. Perkins. Henry Alfred, yes.
And half a sandwich.
Sandwich?
The cheese and chutney, I think.
Oh, yes, he sometimes left that one.
So a formal identification will be required.
It's definitely cheese and chutney.
Of the body. Although there's not much doubt that it is Mr. Perkins.
No.
You go in my car. Take only 10 minutes. Putney Hospital.
Putney Hospital?
He's in the mortuary there. Shall I wait here while you get your handbag? Okay, but will you be all right? You look a bit groggy.
Yes, well, if your husband had been trussed and waited...
Is there somebody else in the house?
What?
To look after you.
Yes, my sister's staying.
Sister, that's good.
Yes, Adelaide. They're upstairs. Adelaide and Percy.
They'll be able to keep an eye on you then.
I'll
wait in the car while you tell your sister the sad news about her husband.
Yes.
Would you believe it? 150 short.
I would not. This gentleman's a policeman.
Policeman? From Fulham?
Putney, actually. Putney. Detective Sergeant Slater.
He's brought some very disturbing news, and I don't know how to handle it.
You just sit down, Jean.
I'm better standing. I can get to the drinks more easily.
Well, what seems to be the problem, Sergeant? I'm Mr. Perkins.
Mr. Perkins?
Yes, that's right.
You're a relative, are you?
Relative of who?
Henry Alfred Perkins.
I am Henry.
Yes, he is. He's a relative. He's Henry's brother.
Henry's brother.
My poor dear Henry's brother.
Oh, well, I have a shock for you, Mr. Perkins.
Yes, I was beginning to think you might have.
Shall I tell him all of you?
It's going to be a shock whoever tells him.
We have every reason to believe that Henry Perkins is dead.
Yes, that's a shock, all right.
He's been murdered.
Has he?
That seems to fit the facts of the case, sir.
Foul play!
Two bullet wounds in the back of his head, and his body had been taken from the river at Putney.
He was trussed up and weighted down.
Yes, yes, that's foul play, all right. Why exactly?
And all he had with him was his briefcase.
Is this your brother's briefcase, Mr. Perkins?
Oh, yes, that certainly looks like my poor brother Henry's briefcase, yes.
And it's all wet.
Oh, dear, oh, dear, oh, dear.
And since Mrs. Perkins is the next of kin, she will be required to make a formal identification of the body.
The body that is found in the Thames?
Yes.
Oh, that'll be Mr. Nasty. Nasty! Very, very nasty.
Henry!
No, you can't call Henry back, Jean. If Henry's gone to heaven, he's gone to heaven. You'll have to rely on me now, his little brother, Freddy. you'll have to excuse my wife. You'll have to excuse my wife. I don't know where she could have got to. I'm sure she would have liked to have been here to comfort Jean, but Genevieve, that's my wife. Genevieve must be lying down resting before she and I depart for Sydney.
Sydney, you're a long way from home.
Yes, the wife and I, that's Genevieve, we've been over here on holiday. Makes a change from the old farm back home, you know. Not so many sheep in Fulham. Well, poor Henry, this is going to be a heel of a shock for Genevieve.
And we have to tell Adelaide and Percy as well.
Yes, them too. Well, this will really put the family arrangements right out of the spout, won't it? I tell you what, I think we all need a quick cup of tea. Why don't you wait over here in the... you wait in the dining room.
A cup of tea certainly wouldn't do Mrs. Perkins any harm.
I prefer a whiskey.
One bright spot, Mrs. Perkins, that so many of your family were here at the time.
Yes, that is a comfort, yes.
I'm waiting. 150.
That's my other brother. That's Archie. Archie's waiting for me to come back and finish playing that game of darts. 150. Oh, Archie's good, he is.
Oh, Henry.
No. You can't call him, Jean.
Henry.
I'm Freddy. She just can't accept that he's gone. It's me, Freddy. Henry's brother, Freddy Perkins. Poor Henry's dead now, but Freddy and Genevieve will look after you.
What are we going to do?
We're going to pray, that's what we're going to do. We're going to pray very, very hard. For Henry. Look, you wait there in the dining room, and while Mrs. Perkins and I are making a quick cup of tea, we'll tell Archie the sad news about Henry.
Oh, God.
And Archie can tell Percy and Adelaide. And Percy and Adelaide can tell Genevieve. Yeah, it's all right, you don't have to tell anyone.
This is catastrophic!
It's nothing of the sort, it's a double bonus.
Double bonus?
Yes, as it's Henry Perkins who's been shot, trussed and drowned, no one will think of looking for him, living the life of luxury in the Barcelona foothills.
And what's the other bonus?
As it's Mr. Nasty who's been shot, trussed and drowned, Mr. Nasty can't come after us.
No, but whoever did the shooting, trussing and drowning, Ken.
You always look on the black side, Jean. Right, let's get rid of Brother Archie first.
Brother Archie?
Yes, yeah, Sergeant Davenport, that bent copper, he's 150 short. Where's my briefcase? There we go.
Should have told the truth from the beginning.
You keep saying that, but you were the one who invented Percy and Adelaide, then killed me off, and then made me christen myself Freddy. Oh, go on.
Hello? I can't follow what you're saying.
Who is it?
I don't know. He's foreign.
Foreign? Hello? Will you speak English, please? Look, if this is some kind of obscene telephone call... What? He just keeps saying briefcase.
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 What?
He's saying briefcase.
account number.
That must be Mr. Big.
Mr. Big?
The one who put Mr. Nasty in the river.
Well, how the hell did he get our telephone number?
Well, bloody brokers.
But Sergeant Slater's got that.
But who had it first? Mr. Nasty delivered it to Mr. Big. Mr. Big opened it, expecting to find £1,135,000, instead of which he sees a cheese and chutney sandwich and your cell phone.
You're right. That's what must have happened. Right. Fit.
Oh. We've fixed Bill's bumper.
Great. Come on.
Come on. Where to?
To the airport, for heaven's sake.
You can't go now.
Well, now's a damn fine time if you ask me.
I can't go either. I've got that other police sergeant waiting for me.
What other police sergeant?
Never mind, Vic.
We've got one in the kitchen and one in the dining room.
One in the kitchen and one in the dining room.
Never mind, Vic.
I've got to go to the mortuary.
Go to the mortuary?
Never mind, Vic. You are going to Barcelona with me. Vic, give the one in the kitchen his 150.
I thought it was 25,000.
It is. It's 150 short. Just give it to him.
To identify the dead body.
Dead body?
Vic!
What dead body?
Mr. Nasty's been found in the river. His arms and legs tied together with rope. Two gaping bullet wounds in the back of his head.
Gee, you are not the news of the bloody world. Vic, just give the sergeant his 150, then you get Betty and you go home as soon as you can. You haven't been here tonight, you haven't seen anything, you don't know anything.
You can say that again.
Just give him his 150, and you wait outside. I'll get your toothbrush. Oh, don't answer it!
Well, I wasn't going to. Why aren't you answering it?
It's him.
Who?
Mr. Nasty.
Well, Mr. Nasty's in the river.
It's not Mr. Nasty, it's Mr. Big.
Oh, yes, I meant Mr. Big.
Do I know Mr. Big?
Mr. Brevkos.
Mr. Who?
Mr. Sparrow.
Who is? Mr. Brevkos.
Mr. Briefcase.
Who the hell's Mr. Briefcase? How the hell did he get your telephone number?
Via my cheese and chutney sandwich. It doesn't matter. That again.
I'll get her a brandy.
No, she's had enough already.
Come on, Bill's waiting. What's the matter with Jean?
She's having hysterics.
She's drunk.
That too.
Hello?
No!
Shh! I beg your pardon.
No!
Brevkos? That wasn't very nice.
You don't have to be nice to Mr. Nasty.
Mr. Nasty, been trusted and waited.
He was, I meant Mr. Big.
Who's Mr. Big?
The one who trusted and waited Mr. Nasty.
It's Mr. Brevkos.
Mr. Briefcase.
Oh, bloody hell. What exactly's happened to Mr. Nasty?
Mr. Big put him in the river.
Oh, jeez.
Put him in the river?
Two gaping bullet wounds in the back of his head.
Oh, good God.
Come on, drink this.
Oh, thanks.
Henry, tell him you'll give him his money back.
No way.
Besides, it's 25,000 short now.
Yes, I'll probably get kneecapped just for that.
Just offer to pay the 25
back. What? Over the next 25 years?
He'll understand. Just tell him you'll give him the money back.
He's right, old man. I mean, it's all getting a bit hot now. I mean, a dead body, two police forces, and a foreign Mr. Brevkos. Oh, well done.
Oh, thank God.
And the same to you.
Henry!
Mr. Big's not going to like that.
Good for you, Henry.
Betty!
You know, this is nothing to do with us. This is between Henry and Mr. Big.
I have been given this opportunity, and I am grabbing it with both hands.
Betty, give Henry his present. Thank you for a lovely evening, and thanks for a delicious dinner.
We haven't had any dinner.
Good. We'll pick up a takeaway on the way home and watch telly.
Watch the telly? We've got Crime Watch for real here.
Betty, go home. Go with Vic, for God's sake. You seem to be taking an awful long.
Perkins residence?
Pardon? Is there anyone here called Brevkos?
No, I don't think so, no.
No, you get on to directory inquiry, sir. I don't believe we've met, madam. Detective Sergeant Davenport, Fulham CID.
Oh, yes, I've heard about you.
All good, I hope.
Patchy.
I was expecting you back in the kitchen, Mr. Perkins, with the rest of your charitable contribution.
Oh, yes, yes, he went out with it. You wait in the kitchen and I'll get some more.
Oh, you seem to have quite a stash of cash hidden away, Mr. Perkins.
Nothing
is anybody going to Heathrow?
Ah, it's Ben.
It's Bill, and somebody's going to get a bloody big bill at the end of today. Now, is it you, the in-laws, or the outlaws?
It's nobody.
Nobody?
Yes, it is. Mr. and Mrs. Brown.
Mr. and Mrs. Brown?
Yes.
Where did they come from?
They're our in-laws.
Oh, so it's not you then?
No. Wait outside.
How long for?
For as long as it takes.
Yeah, I'm not hanging about much longer. 5 minutes and I'm off.
There'll be less than 5 minutes. Now take Mr. and Mrs. Brown's suitcase and wait outside.
What? Just the one?
Yes.
And they come all the way from Australia?
Yes.
What are your in-laws? Nudists?
Damn taxi drivers.
He's got a point though, hasn't he? I mean, two people, round the world trip, one suitcase. Are Mr. and Mrs. Brown nudists, Mrs. Perkins?
Only when they've got their clothes off.
Mrs. Perkins is getting upset.
Mrs. Perkins is getting drunk.
She's not used to alcohol.
But I'm learning fast.
She and Adelaide are very close, and Australia's such a long way off.
You know, I kind of got the impression that it was perhaps you and Mrs. Perkins that were planning a sudden little trip abroad.
Ah,
taxi driver seemed to think it a possibility too.
No, no.
You'd need a lot of cash for a trip like that.
No, no, we don't want to go abroad, do we, Jean?
I bloody don't.
No, no, we're staying here. It's Mr. and Mrs. Brown who are going to Sydney, back to the farm and the jolly old clippers.
So where are they then, your in-laws?
Mr. and Mrs. Brown?
Yes.
Percy and Adelaide.
Percy's outside, isn't he, Henry?
Oh, yes, yes. Thanks for reminding me. Yes, yes. Percy's outside and...
And I'm Adelaide. Adelaide. Jean's sister from Sydney.
Yes, yes.
Sister from Sydney!
She's been like that all day. She'll be inconsolable when you're gone, Adelaide. Well, there you are. You've met Mrs. Brown.
And what about your husband?
No, you don't want to meet Mr. Brown.
I've been waiting for you outside.
Speak of the devil! You ask where he is, and lo and behold, we were just talking about you, me old bluey sport digger.
Bluey sport digger?
Indeed we were, me and the gentleman from the kitchen.
Oh, the kitchen?
Yes, 150, thank you. There we are, that should make up the shortfall, 25,000. Careful how you cross the road.
Oh, and you have a safe journey then, Mr. Brown.
Mr. Brown?
He's a bit deaf.
Deaf?
Yes, we know, dear. He said have a safe journey.
Am I hearing straight?
Not yet, but you will after the operation. It's been a lovely visit.
Is Jean still in a bit of a state?
Yes.
Jean's upstairs. She's very, very upset about us leaving.
Well, perhaps we should stay then.
No, don't be daft. You've got to get back to the farm.
Farm?
The farm!
Sydney!
Oh, pleased to meet you.
I can see you sad there, but it's going to be perhaps you're going to leave us to it, Father.
Yes, right, Mr. Perkins. It's been a most rewarding little visit. I hope you find your sheep in good shape.
Outside and came back in again.
It doesn't matter, Vic. Betty, take him home. Come on, Jean, we're off.
Excuse me. Is that, I think you said something about a cup of tea, Mr. Perkins.
You're new around here, aren't
you? I'm sorry, tea's on its way. This gentleman is from the dining room.
Let's go home while we're still reasonably sane.
What the hell are you up to?
I'm getting a glass of hot milk and several aspirins.
Oh, you'll make yourself ill. You've been drinking.
Oh, good idea.
What the dickens are you doing in your pyjamas?
I'm going to bed. Who's been in my brandy?
Jean, you have two choices and bed isn't one of them.
What are the two choices?
Barcelona or the mortuary?
Take Barcelona.
Will you stop trying to run my life for me?
Well, you obviously don't know which direction to take. Why would she have to go to the mortuary?
Never mind.
Because Sergeant Slater thinks Mr. Nasty's body is Henry.
What? Does Vic know about this added complication?
God knows what Vic knows, but don't confuse him anymore.
Betty, are you coming home or not?
I'm trying to sort out these two.
These two don't need sorting out. I'm going to bed and he's going to Barcelona.
Barcelona?
Bet, it's Barcelona with me or Sergeant Slater with the dead Mr. Nasty.
Blimey, you walk out of the door of this place, when you come back you're in cuckoo land.
Vic, go home, please.
Yes, the happy birthday celebrations are over.
Jean, you are well on your way to getting sloshed.
Betty, I've already arrived. I'm getting several aspirins and sleeping in the spare room.
You are sleeping in Barcelona with me.
Find yourself a bull and sleep with that.
Jean! Vic, even with a satellite dish, you can't get any better than this.
If Jean makes us miss that plane.
Jean's not going, Henry.
Oh, yes, she is. Vic, go make sure that taxi driver doesn't push off without us. You give him £50 and finish your way.
I'm getting Betty and I'm taking her home.
I'll get Betty. You go and see Ben.
It's Bill.
Bill, Ben, whoever he is. Give him £50 and then he's got to leave without us.
Right, where's Mr. Perkins then?
we weren't expecting you back, Sergeant.
Is that why you're looking so guilty?
Guilty? Ask me. We're not looking guilty, are we, Percy?
No, we're not looking guilty, Henry, no.
No, we're just sitting here, aren't we, Percy?
That's right, Henry, relaxing.
Yes, under the blanket, having a little,
what, Mr. Perkins?
Well, you know.
No, I don't know, Mr. Perkins.
Well, but we know, don't we, Percy?
I don't.
I see.
I don't at all.
It's all right, Percy. He knows what you get up to when you've been away from home, on the farm, with no company but your sheep. Yes.
You seem to be having a very busy evening, Mr. Perkins.
Yes, it's my lucky night, isn't it? What can we do for you, Sergeant? We're in a bit of a hurry.
Oh, is that a fact?
Yes, Mr. Brown is keen to get on an aeroplane.
A new position, is that?
No. Can we be of any assistance?
Well, I don't quite know, Mr. Perkins. See, I'm still trying to sort it all out.
No, you don't want to do that, does he, Percy?
Definitely not, Henry, no.
See, I actually came back to tell Mr. Brown about his taxi driver.
Bill?
He's driven off.
Driven off?
In a bit of a huff.
A huff?
You seem very concerned about your brother-in-law's taxi, Mr. Perkins.
Yes, well, I know how anxious he is to get back to the farm. It's the lambing season, isn't it, Percy?
Is it?
Percy, why is Bill driven off in a huff?
He said you've been mucking him about.
Damn cheek.
Oh, and he's left your suitcase out on the pavement, Mr. Brown.
What suitcase?
The little suitcase containing your boomerang and didgeridoo, Percy.
That suitcase?
Yes, you travel light because you and your wife are nudists.
Nudists?
We explained it's only when you've got no clothes on, Percy.
God, I wish I stayed in bed this morning.
Anyway, I'll bring you the suitcase for you, shall I?
No, please don't trouble yourself. He wants it left outside, don't you, Percy?
How do I know what I want?
Please don't bother.
Okay, suit yourselves. Must be getting awfully steamy under that blanket.
God!
Oh, shut up, Vic. It could have been worse.
Worse? That police sergeant thinks I'm a pervert.
Be grateful he didn't make a pass at you. Now look, I'll grab Jean, we're going to go out the back way. Right, give me the keys to your car.
My car? What for?
Well, to get to the airport. Our taxi driver's pushed off, hasn't he?
I'm not giving you my car.
Well, I don't know, when you are.
I like my car.
5,000.
10.
7.5.
Done.
Henry!
Go! Oh. Excuse me, Jean.
Jean's getting quietly faster than there.
Well, why didn't you take the brandy bottle away from her?
She's finished the brandy. She's on the cooking sherry now.
Oh, silly woman.
Henry, she's determined to stay. She doesn't want to go first class to Barcelona or anywhere else.
Oh,
silly woman.
First class to the Old Bailey, that's what I'll get.
The Old Bailey?
Henry's just told that bent copper that he's been having it off with me here, and I've been having it off with a sheep in Sydney.
What did you say a thing like that?
No, it seemed like the right thing to say at the time. Right, let me give you your 7,500.
What's that for?
His car.
7,500? The garage told you they wouldn't give you 500 for it.
500? It's a seller's market.
Excuse me.
Is that tea?
Maybe we should forget about it. You just get your sister in law, will you, sir?
Actually, Sergeant, Mrs. Perkins is still trying to pull herself together.
Why don't I help Mrs. Perkins make the tea, Sergeant?
That's a very good idea, Adelaide.
Adelaide?
Adelaide!
Adelaide, so you're Mrs. Perkins' sister, are you?
Sister?
Sister.
I'll take you the lady's husband.
Well, I think that still works, yes.
My husband and I are from Sydney.
Sydney?
Oh, my God.
Well, that's a coincidence.
Why, are you from Sydney?
No, I am.
Oh, you're from Sydney.
You know I am, me and my wife.
Oh, yes, I know your wife, but
Genevieve.
Oh,
Percy, I'll make the tea.
Can I just clarify something about Genevieve?
Not now, Percy.
You all flew from Sydney together, did you?
Yes, that's correct. Percy and Adelaide, me and Genevieve.
And do you have a father's wealth?
As well as what?
As well as me, Percy. There's a bit of rivalry between us, you know. The Perkins and the Browns. In-laws, you know. Percy being married to the sister of my brother's wife.
I understand.
Percy, why don't you go help Adelaide make the tea?
Henry, I have...
No! I told you you weren't to mention that name, Percy.
What name, Henry?
That name, Percy. I might break down and weep. I'd appreciate it if you just leave us alone in our hour of sorrow.
Look, Henry.
No! It's too fresh, Percy.
It's fresh, Henry.
No, Henry's not fresh. Not anymore. Look, will you please wait in the dining room?
He does know, doesn't he?
Yes, he knows. I told him.
Told me what?
That Henry Perkins is dead.
Oh, my God.
How do you mean dead?
I thought you said you told him.
Yes, I did, but I only got as far as Henry not looking too well.
His body was found on the Putney Bridge.
Putney Bridge?
In the river.
Do I know about the river?
Yes, I told you, but I only got as far as Henry not looking too well.
Henry, in the river?
I told you, he was shot, trussed and drowned and not looking too well.
Oh, shot, trussed and drowned.
Yes.
Well, that would explain why he wasn't looking too well.
I was trying to break it to Percy gently. That they identified Henry by his briefcase.
Ah, yes, his briefcase.
Yes, poor Henry, that's all he had with him. A few papers, a cell phone and half a cheese and chutney sandwich.
Dear, oh dear, oh dear, oh dear. I mean, poor Jean must be knocked sideways.
Yes.
Luckily, she had a brother-in-law at the time.
Oh, my God.
I thought I was her brother-in-law.
You are, so am I. Only we from different sides of the family. You married to Jean's sister, Adelaide, and I'm the brother of Jean's late husband, Henry.
That's something else I know, is it?
You can see why I had to break it to him slowly. He hasn't been the same since he fell off that kangaroo pillow. Jean has two brothers-in-law. You, Percy, and me, good old reliable Freddy.
You know, I think I got it. Good old reliable Freddy. You're reliable Freddy. I'm Australian Percy, and Henry's dead, right?
Right.
And we're both brothers-in-law to Jean, yes?
Yes.
Right, got it.
And so's Archie.
Oh, my God. Archie. I'd forgotten about Archie.
Well, he's a brother-in-law.
Yes, not so reliable Archie.
Not so reliable Archie.
Did Archie come over from Sydney too?
No, he didn't, did he, Percy?
No, he's
from Manchester. He's a travelling salesman.
Yes.
That's what makes him so reliable.
Yes.
Well, on the subject of Archie.
Are we not, Percy? Unreliable Archie has gone. He's taken his samples up to Manchester with him, and he's not coming back.
Well, here we are. Down the road, and I thought I can't leave that suitcase sitting out on the pavement like that.
Certainly not. So he came back for it. Great.
So there you are, Percy. One suitcase.
Well, thank you, Archie.
I beg your pardon?
I said thank you, Archie.
Yes, we know what you said, Percy. Unreliable Archie is back.
Not so unreliable after all.
No. Oh, Archie.
Archie?
Oh, Archie, you haven't actually met this gentleman, have you?
No.
Good. This is Detective Sergeant Slater.
How do you do?
Are you a policeman?
I thought you'd be surprised, Archie.
Buckley, eh?
And this is Archie. Archie Perkins.
Oh. Archie Perkins!
My big brother.
Your big brother.
And his big brother-in-law.
And his big brother-in-law.
It's marvellous the way the family has rallied round so quickly.
You have to, don't you? Weren't you hoping to catch the overnight train to Manchester, Archie?
Well, I was, yes. But I'm beginning to think I should stay.
No. There's no need to, is there, Percy?
Well, none that I can think of. No, there's no need. Freddy.
Oh, Freddy!
You've got to catch your train, Archie, and the next time I see you, I'll reimburse you the cost of your ticket and all your expenses.
No, I'm in no hurry, actually, Freddy.
Yes, you are, Archie. You've got to get back on the road.
On the road?
Yes, selling whatever travelling salesmen are selling these days.
Oh, yes. No, I've got the weekend off.
Anyway, he probably wants to stay for the funeral.
Oh, my God.
Oh, there's a funeral, is there?
Don't you know, sir?
Oh, not the exact details, no.
Well, I expect Freddy had only got as far as him not looking too well.
Yes, thank you, Percy, I had. The sad fact is, Archie, Henry died.
Oh, no, Freddy.
Oh, yes, Archie.
You know, the last time I saw Henry, I thought he was looking a bit pale, Percy.
Well, he was drowned in the river, Archie.
Percy, spare Archie the details, please.
No, I think you should give me the details, please.
I'm afraid your brother Henry was found dead in the river at Putney. His arms and his legs had been tied together, and he'd been shot in the back of his head.
I always said Henry had these suicidal tendencies.
I regret to say it looks like murder, Mr. Perkins. I'm waiting for Mrs. Perkins to accompany me to the mortuary as soon as she had a cup of tea.
Yes, well, now you clearly intend to stay for the funeral, Archie.
Oh, I wouldn't miss it for the world, Freddy.
Yes, well, Percy.
I don't think I can manage the funeral, Freddy.
Yes, Percy. You stay here while I sort out Sergeant Slater, Jean, and the mortuary. You accompany my brother Archie into the dining room.
I don't think that's a very good idea.
Yes, discuss how much cash Archie might expect to get from poor Henry's will.
Now, I think that's a very good idea.
Yes, and I'll send you in a quick cup of tea.
I hope it's quicker than the one I've had.
Come on, Percy, you can fill in some of the blank spots for me.
There's no need to fill in all the blank spots, Percy.
I don't know the answer to any of the blank spots.
Just plead ignorance. Right, Sergeant, where were we?
Well, before the family gathering, I was waiting for Mrs. Perkins to pull herself together and a cup of tea. Yes.
Don't care! Go to bed, Jean!
Going to bed?
In the spare room!
You can't go to bed, you're leaving for the mortuary.
She can't go to the mortuary dressed like this.
I'm going to bed with a glass of hot milk and several aspirins in the spare room.
She just can't bear to be in her own bed without Henry.
I could care less about Henry.
Oh, that's a bit callous, I must say.
Well, she obviously can't forgive Henry for suddenly dying like this. On his birthday as well.
Perkins died on his birthday.
Yes, we never expected Henry would snuff it before the candles.
Aren't you going to answer that?
No, it's the wrong number.
How do you know?
I can tell by the ring.
Hello. What? Brofkas. No, the wrong number. You were right. You should get your number changed.
Oh, that's a very good idea, Sergeant. Look, why don't you make some tea in the kitchen while I go see to Mrs. Perkins?
Well, okay, but we must get her to the mortuary.
We aren't dealing with human emotions here, Sergeant.
I understand. Perhaps I will get Mrs. Perkins a box.
Oh, God, no, we haven't got room for anyone else in here. Come on, Jean, we're off!
Henry!
Oh!
Henry is in the mortuary in Putney.
Henry's bloody lucky, I can tell you.
What's the matter?
Making a right cock-up in there with Sergeant Davenport.
I thought you were pleading ignorance.
Well, so far, my pleading ignorance has cost you another £20,000.
£20,000?
First of all, he wants £10,000 for not spilling the beans about Henry, Percy, Freddie and Archie.
Cardi, what's the other £10,000 for?
It's £5,000 apiece for not spilling the beans about our hanky-panky under the blanket.
That's outrageous, and I'm not paying your £5,000 for a stop.
Henry!
Vic, Jean's locked herself in the loo.
Good.
Well, she's turned the radio on full blast. I can't make myself heard.
Sounds like utter bliss.
Oh, Vic! just checking on my Percy. I can't quite see what he's doing in there with the Freddy and Archie.
I'll get the cups.
Why the hell didn't you leave the talking to me?
What's happened?
Your husband only blurts out how much money was in Mr. Nasty's briefcase, and he was happy to settle for an extra £10,000.
I'm sorry, Henry.
You start saying it's easier to deal in percentages. Well, it's cost me 5% of £1,135,000.
Yes, but he did agree that it was all inclusive. The original 25, your dead body, and our hanky panky under the blanket.
Your hanky panky under the blanket?
Never mind. Where's Jean?
She's locked in the loo listening to classic FM.
Ask a silly question. Right, let's pay off Sergeant Davenport first.
Right.
Oh!
No.
What can we do for you, Sergeant?
I was wondering.
How many cups?
What?
Who's having tea?
Oh, the whole family, except Mrs. Perkins.
And what about Archie?
No, he's having nothing but champagne from now on. No, it's just the three of us. You've been most kind.
Mrs. Perkins' condition hasn't improved then?
No.
No, I'm afraid not.
Well, I've been thinking.
You don't want to do that.
It doesn't actually have to be Mrs. Perkins.
What doesn't?
To identify the body. It's not legally necessary. If she's not up to it physically or emotionally, and with all that alcohol...
You mean somebody else could identify Henry?
Any relative would be officially acceptable. You could do it.
Me? Me? No. I couldn't identify Mr. Perkins.
Well, some other close relative then.
No, not me.
It's not unusual for one of the gentlemen in the bereaved family to volunteer for the job.
I never volunteer on principle.
It's not a bad idea, Percy.
It's a very good idea, Percy.
Identify that body as Henry Perkins.
Please, Percy.
I just remembered I can't.
Why not?
Well, we're leaving for Australia in 5 minutes.
Take the next flight.
And you'll be well paid.
Pay? There's no payment in this, Mr. Perkins.
There might be.
Oh, here, for Percy.
Expenses?
He's only got to go to Putney.
Yes, but he's come all the way from Australia, hasn't he? Look, why don't you let the family sort this out privately, and by the time you've made the coffee, we would have resolved the situation.
I've already made tea.
Yes, thank you, but Mrs. Perkins prefers coffee.
Vic, go to the mortuary, please.
Identify that body as Henry Perkins. Definitely not.
You're being very unhelpful, Vic. You
have no right to involve us in his nefarious activities.
And I'm prepared to pay cash.
What?
10,000.
30.
20.
25.
Done.
It's amazing how it goes, isn't it?
I'm very surprised at you, Vic. First, the Carnarvons. You don't take money for helping a friend.
He's not a friend. He's family.
Vicky, go get Jean down here fast.
I told you, she's locked herself in the loo.
Break the door down.
Break the door? Oh, this is living.
Right, give me the keys to your car.
You give him the money first.
Blimey, you're a tough negotiator, Vic.
It's a cruel world, Henry. That's 25,000 for identifying the body, plus 7,500 for the car.
I know that.
That comes to £32,500.
I know that too.
Mr. Perkins.
Oh, it's you.
Thanks for waiting.
Something popped up.
Oh. Your secret's safe with me. Provided, of course, I get that additional charitable donation we agreed upon.
All right, all right.
%, I think you said, Mr. Perkins.
I didn't say it, he said it. There. That's less than 25,000 you've already had.
Oh, quite right. All in a good cause.
And that's yours. 25,000.
Thank you.
Plus the 7,500 for a car worth £500.
You're not diddling him as well, are you, Percy?
I'm being paid for services rendered.
You saucy thing.
Excuse me. Mr. Perkins, where do you keep the coffee?
He's caught the three of us at it now. We like to keep things in the family, don't we, Percy?
Thank you, Archie.
I just came to ask where Mrs. Perkins keeps the coffee.
Oh, in the cupboard over the sink.
Are you sure you all want coffee now?
Ooh, not half. Thirsty work, this.
Thank you, Archie.
Well, let's forget about the coffee, shall
it
we?
It is a penalty.
That's a good idea, Sergeant. Especially as Percy is now ready to accompany you to the mortuary.
Oh, thank heavens for that. You've decided to accept your obligation, have you?
Yes.
Well, let's get moving, Mr. Brown.
Could you just give me 5 minutes to get ready?
5 minutes?
Yes, he's got his hands full at the moment.
I'll wait for you in the car. Mr. Brown, you can sit in the back.
You rock the devil.
Oh, only a bit of fun, please. Well, it's been a real pleasure doing business with you, Mr. Perkins.
Thank you.
Oh, by the way, Percy here was telling me that you're leaving soon for Barcelona.
Percy should keep his trap shut.
No, like I said, your secret's safe with me. You'll like it in Spain, though. You'll really fit in there.
Full of Englishmen, you mean?
No, full of crooks.
Well, crooks or no crooks, you game with Sergeant Stager to the mortuary. I pale Sergeant Davenport, and Barcelona, here I come. What are you doing, Vic?
Shush, I'm just checking you haven't shortchanged me.
Vic, I want you to know, your wife has broken our bathroom door down and assaulted my person.
Be quiet. You're going to Barcelona with Henry.
I can't even say bathroom door.
And he's giving you £1,000 a week for housekeeping, aren't you, Henry?
£1,000?
I wouldn't go even if he offered me 500.
And you can get dressed in Vic's car on the way.
I'm not getting Vic's car.
Well, it might not look much, but your husband's paid him 7,500 for it.
And a further 25,000 to go to the mortuary.
Vic's going to the mortuary?
Yes.
And that's what happens when you leave the room for 5 minutes.
Lovely. Vic's going to the mortuary, I'm going to bed, and Henry's going to Barcelona.
Jean, put your coat on.
I don't need a coat in bed.
Jean! You're going with Henry.
Why won't anyone listen? I don't want to spend the rest of my life as Mrs. Shufflebottom in Barcelona.
We will discuss this on the plane. You're a little bit sloshed.
Henry, there's nothing to discuss, and I'm a lot sloshed.
Henry?
What?
It's all here.
Good.
Here the car,
thank you.
Jean, he's your husband. Better or worse, richer or poorer.
Insanity wasn't on the list.
You'll push me too far, you will, Jean. I'll go by myself, I will. I'll go by myself, on the plane, by myself to Barcelona.
I hope you have a good flight, Henry.
Oh, Betty.
Jean, for heaven's sake, Henry needs looking after.
Then he'll have to find another Mrs. Shufflebottom to look after him, won't he?
Don't think I couldn't. Sure, there must be 1,000 women out there who would jump at the chance of sharing my new life with me in Barcelona.
Name one.
More than 1,000.
Come on, name me one woman.
Betty Johnson.
What?
Well, I would. I mean, I think it sounds brilliant. I'd go like a shot.
You what?
Well, if you don't fancy it, and if Henry would take me.
Betty.
There is something wrong with my hearing.
I've never heard of anything so moral. Henry, tell her she gets off.
You get off in Barcelona, Betty.
Just a minute. Just, what about me?
Well, you won't go, will you?
You can still change your mind, you know, Jean.
Well, I don't want to spoil anyone's fun.
You understand, don't you, Vic?
Hang on a second. Jean can't stay here. Mr. Bing will have this place surrounded by tomorrow.
There's only one thing for it.
What's that?
This Jean will have to go and live with Vic.
Hang on. Hang on.
She'll be safe with Vic.
Hang on.
Betty, you're an absolute brick.
Hang on.
Just a minute.
Well, if you won't go, it'll stop me worrying if I know you're safe with Vic and Clapham. Thanks, Vic. Well,
don't mention it.
Right, we're all ready to get going then. I'll say goodbye then, Jean.
Yes?
I won't be able to make any contact with you.
No.
Oh, Betty, do you have an up-to-date passport?
It's at home.
It's all right, we'll pick it up on the way to the airport.
God, this is exciting, isn't it, Vic?
Fantastic. You look after my wife, Henry.
And you look after mine, Vic. Go on. Sergeant Slater's waiting out there to take you to the mortuary. Jean, we'll drop you off at Betty's place when we go pick up her passport.
We're leaving the house in a bit of a mess, Henry.
You can tidy up mine. It's disgusting.
Okay, are we ready then?
Ah, it's Ben.
Bill.
Bill, we were told you'd gone off in a huff.
Yes, well, I realised that wasn't very professional.
Quite right.
Besides, I wouldn't have got my fare paid, would I? Now then, I'm taking Mr. and Mrs. Brown in my taxi to Heathrow Airport, right?
No, Mr. and Mrs. Brown have gone by the board.
Gone by the board?
Never mind, I'm going to the airport.
I thought you said you weren't.
Never mind.
Okay, let's get moving then.
No, I'm going in Mr. Johnson's car, but you can take Mrs. Perkins now that you're here.
To Heathrow?
No, to Mrs. Johnson's house in Clapham Common.
So, you're going to the airport, and I'm taking you to Clapham Common.
That's where I'm living now.
So you and Mrs. Perkins are coming with me to Clapham.
No, Mrs. Perkins is going to Clapham. I'm going to Barcelona.
Barcelona?
Yes.
Oh, so you and your wife are going to Barcelona now, are you?
No, she's going to Barcelona. I'm going to the mortuary with the police.
To the mortuary with the police?
I'm going to Barcelona.
With his fellow's wife?
That's right. Now, come on.
Hold on.
He's taken your wife to Barcelona.
Yes. And you're going to live with him in Clapham.
Yes.
I don't understand how me and the missus missed out on this sexual revolution.
Just wait outside. Come on, we've got to get going. Jean, put your coat on properly.
Oh, God, someone's stolen one of my sleeves.
Is the suitcase going to Clapham Common or to the airport?
It doesn't matter.
Of course it matters. The one's west and the other's south.
Just do as you're told.
I'm getting road rage.
Wait outside. Oh, Vic, please, go to the mortuary.
I just want to make sure there's no more change of plans. The rate we're going, I'll come home and find you waiting for me in bed.
Bed. How'd you keep your nighties, Betty?
I don't wear nighties.
Don't you?
Henry!
Sorry, Vic.
Oh, Vic, will you get going? Well, this is it then.
Okay. Oh, my God.
What now?
No, this is serious.
What is it?
Pussy.
Pussy?
Our ginger cat.
Oh, never mind the cat, let's go!
No, hang on, one of us has got to have pussy!
You'll get enough pussy in Barcelona, and I've come here.
Betty! No, hang on, where is she? No, Mr. Big will have his place surrounded by them.
Oh my God, Mr. Big.
I bet you left the cat flap open.
Well, he wouldn't come in through the cat flap.
Oh, cat,
that's
what
I'm oh no.
You're going to bed at our place.
Right.
Mr. Brown. I believe I said 5 minutes.
You said it very nicely.
You did indeed, Sergeant. Come on, Percy, that's enough hanky-panky for one evening. And we've all said our fond farewells, haven't we?
Well, why not? Mortuary is as good a place as anywhere else.
Life's funny. 1 minute you're bowling merrily along, the sun is shining and the birds are singing, and then whack, all of a sudden, you're on your way to the mortuary.
That was quite poetic. You're coming for Vic.
Never mind, Vic. Let's get you to the taxi. We've got 45 minutes to check in.
Absolutely.
Puss.
Never mind, Pussy. The neighbours will look after her.
Are you sure?
Positive. They're always feeding her.
I couldn't eat a thing, honestly.
Excuse me. Oh! It's just that I've been waiting.
We'll carry on waiting.
The telephone's ringing.
We know that.
Taj Mahal Indian takeaway? What? No, I'm not understanding. No, we do Indian takeaway. We do vindaloo, chapati, papadum bhaji. We do Percy bhaji. We do Adelaide bhaji. We do Archie bhaji. No. No, I'm not understanding. Thank you for calling. Bye-bye. Come on, what are you working? Come on, what is
this? Is Mrs. Perkins ready yet?
Very near.
Well, I was just hoping that Mr. Johnson about to depart the old caravan would be on the move.
Mrs. Perkins is coming now.
Yes.
Is that Mrs. Perkins?
Yes, she's a little bit tipsy.
She's totally blasted.
We know that.
You better not get sick in my taxi.
Could you just wait outside and we'll see to Mrs. Perkins?
Yes.
Right. Oh, by the way, I've decided on Clapham Common for that suitcase.
Lovely.
She is still going to Clapham Common, isn't she?
Yes.
Just checking.
344 Clapham Road.
And that's your place?
Yes.
Just checking. And you're still going with him to Barcelona?
That's got nothing to do with you.
But we are stopping at Clapham on the way to the airport.
But Clapham isn't on the way to the airport.
We're having a little diversion.
Oh, is that what they call it now?
Get back in your cab.
Now, come on, Henry.
Oh, right. Come on.
Am I coming or going?
No! Oh, wait a minute.
Oh, you haven't got a dog as well as a cat, have you?
No, I've just realised.
What?
Well, under the circumstances...
What?
We ought to split the cash.
Split it?
Yes, between us. You and me, Jean and Vic. Where's my briefcase? Oh, there. 50-50, half each.
That's very generous of you, Henry.
I thought you didn't want any of our ill-gotten gains.
That's when he was taking me, now he's taking you.
It's only fair, Betty.
Oh, well, be quick, for goodness sake.
Leave it!
It might be Mr. Bing.
All the more reason to leave it. Oh, come on.
Excuse me.
Oh!
I don't know if anybody cares, but the meter now reads £37.50. And the bloody taxi hasn't moved an inch yet. Hello?
No!
No, no, there's nobody called Bruce Kirsten in here.
No!
No, it's Perkins, 42 Alger Avenue.
No!
So all I said was 42 Alger Avenue.
You've given our address to Mr. Big.
Who's Mr. Big?
Who's
Mr. Brooker?
Biggie, get in the car, quick, start the engine. Gene, get in the taxi.
Thank God for that.
No, don't get in the taxi.
Arthur, cry out loud.
We've still got to halve the you-know-what.
Halve the you-know-what?
Shush.
We're never going to get to Barcelona at this rate.
Yeah, when did you elbow Sydney for Barcelona?
Shush.
Gene, you come with us in the car. We can sort out the finances on the way to Clapham.
Good thinking. We don't need that taxi at all.
I don't believe it.
Betty, get Jean in the car.
Aye, aye, aye.
£37.50
gone.
Plus tip.
It'll have to be a £50 note. That's all I've got.
Smashing that up, carry in tank.
If we miss our aeroplane, it'll be all thanks to... Ah! Oh, God almighty!
What's all that noise,
Henry? God almighty!
Anyone fancy a cheesy chocolate sandwich?
Henry!
Oh, I don't mind a cheesy chocolate sandwich.
For God's sake, what happened?
I'll tell you what's happened. Your husband's gone off with Sergeant Slater, who's clutching a briefcase containing £1,135,000.
£1,135,000?
That's it. We've had it. We've lost the lot. I had it all. Barcelona, Bali, bloody wife swapping.
Was that for Thomas?
No, it's back to the office on Monday.
I don't know why, but I suddenly feel very sober.
What do you say to Mr. Big?
Oh my God, Mr. Big!
Will Mr. Big give me my £37.50?
No, he won't!
Henry!
Big!
Henry!
Big! You haven't gone!
No.
Where's Sergeant Slater?
He's outside.
We thought you'd left for the mortuary.
You're not going to believe this.
What, to identify a dead body?
I just have. We've run over your cat.
I'll give you a hand. Yeah, but it'll not squash you just a little bit. Get out!
Look, I'm sorry, Henry.
It's all right, it's all right.
It ran right under the sergeant's car.
It could happen to anyone. Where's the briefcase?
I'm sure it was painless. The briefcase?
Yes, the one with the money.
Well, isn't that it?
No, that's mine.
Well, if that's yours, you mean that's yours? Cheese and chutney yours?
Yes, Sergeant Slater must have taken the other one. Well, where is he?
Well, he's outside digging a hole for the cat.
Somehow we're going to have to swap them back. Good news.
She's all right.
Sergeant Slater!
She's only stunned.
I beg your pardon?
Mrs. Perkins is cut. Dazed, that's all.
Oh! Oh, that's wonderful. Isn't that wonderful, Percy?
Yes, Freddy. It would have been tragic, Jean losing her husband and her cat all in the same day.
So let's get moving, Mr. Brown.
Yes, do you know what, Sergeant?
What?
We never had that cup of tea.
I don't want a cup of tea.
You sit down. You haven't had a break all evening.
I don't want a break. I want to take my leave at 42 Albert Avenue and go to the mortuary of Oscar Brown.
Yes, but a cup of tea would really be nice.
I've waited an hour for a cup of tea. Look, I've been very patient with you.
You certainly have.
And the many members of your large family.
And the many members will remember that. Why don't you let me relieve you?
I don't want you to relieve.
Oh, that's a relief.
Look, I understand the distress that the tragic death of Mr. Perkins has caused.
You've been most kind and sympathetic.
But I must now insist on going to the mortuary with Mr. Brown.
Oh, you don't need to ask. Mr. Brown here is awaiting your pleasure.
Mr. Brown, you are required to accompany me to make a formal identification of the body found in the river at Putney Bridge.
After this, anything would be a relief.
Off you go then, Mr. Brown, Sergeant Slater.
Thank goodness, Pussy's all right, Henry!
Did you hear that, Henry? Pussy's all right!
Let's go.
Vic, you were bloody brilliant. We've got the money back.
I've been more worried about the cat.
I'm halving it with you.
Halving the cat?
Oh, Vic.
Carol's got her at the moment. She's just got a little bump on her head, that's all.
Oh, great.
You don't mind Pussy living with us, do you, Vic?
I'm giving up minding about anything.
Come on.
I'll just get Pussy's cat box, Vic.
Cat box, horse box, chicken box, please yourself.
There's no time to get her cat box.
And I'll just get some cat food.
Mr. Big has our address and he's on his way round here.
Mr. Big has your address?
Yes.
Well, when did that happen?
7¾ minutes ago.
It doesn't matter, he's coming. There's no time to get the cat food.
Let's forget about the cat food. I've got turkey, ice cream, lasagna, ice baked beans.
You haven't got flea powder.
Forget the flea powder.
Yes, forget the flea powder.
Henry?
Betty, we've got the money back.
Oh, Henry, you clever fellow.
Oi! I'm not in Barcelona yet!
Betty, I'll go to you. Remember, we're dropping you off at your place.
Well, if you'll excuse me, I have an appointment at the mortuary.
Well, that's it.
Oh!
Well, that's bloody it! I've waited long enough for you, Mr. Brown.
Yes, well, I'm coming.
So's Christmas.
Well, I'm ready.
That's too late, mate. Where's your sister-in-law?
Macclesfield. Why?
Jean.
Oh, yes, I mean Jean, your mad sister, the mad widow.
and the Mad Widow's coming with me to identify her dead husband, whether she likes it or not.
Oh, I want to do that. I love dead bodies.
Now, Jean can't find the cat box.
Forget about the cat box. Tell her Sister Law she's coming with me to the mortuary.
No. You've got it slightly wrong, Sergeant. Mr. Brown is...
Mr. Brown is as much as everybody else in this family.
That is maybe, but Mr. Brown is coming
with Mrs. Perkins is coming with me to the mortuary, and I don't care if the sight of the blood of her husband's horribly mutilated body gets on a screaming hysterics. Don't tell her, sister, if she's not in her car in 1 minute, I will arrest her.
But Mrs. Perkins is in no condition
you
to go to the...
Shut up! Shut up and shut off and shove yourself right up your sheep in Sydney.
That's the second time he's done that!
He seemed really pleasant when he first arrived.
That's it, Sergeant. Stacey will find the cash, Mr. Big will find us, and we'll find ourselves with Mr. Nasty in the mortuary.
But Henry, we've still got to clear off before Mr. Big arrives.
Oh, God, Mr. Big.
Well, where can Jean and I go? We're broke.
Maybe they'll both have to come and live with us in Clapham now.
Oh, hang on.
I'll grab Jean. Henry, I'm really disappointed about you and me and Barcelona.
Me too, Betty.
Do you think we could have the same arrangement in Clapham?
No, we can't.
Well, maybe once a year, Henry, on your birthday.
I don't know what's come over, Betty.
Betty, it's my birthday today.
Henry!
Sergeant Slater!
That taxi driver of yours just reversed into a police car.
Oh, that's awful.
Which caused my police car to reverse into a pedestrian.
That's terrible.
Is it serious?
He's been hit by a motor vehicle. Of course it's serious.
Oh, why don't you let me relieve
you? If you come anywhere near me, so help me, you will join your brother on that slap in the mortuary.
Point taken.
I've called for an ambulance. I'll have to wait until all is sorted out.
In the meantime, would it be all right if I left for Australia?
You stay put.
Of course.
You tell the sister-in-law she's coming with me as soon as I've ascertained the extent of that fellow's injuries.
I was wondering if I could just...
You couldn't! Where does Mrs. Perkins keep her first aid kit?
In the bathroom cabinet upstairs.
Right.
Sergeant!
What?
Could I come upstairs and relieve
you? No, you couldn't!
Sergeant! Catch!
One of you two gentlemen, please be so good to tell the taxi driver not to leave the premises. He may be needed as a material witness.
Of course.
And perhaps you could try and keep your hands off each other for just 5 minutes.
That way, that's two police forces having on their records now.
Oh, Mick.
Oh, Henry, I'm so sorry.
Why, what's happened now?
Betty just told me Sergeant Slater's got your money.
Oh, that's yesterday's news, isn't it, Vic?
Yes, Barcelona's on again.
Certainly is.
Is that the one with the cat?
Yes.
Oh, that's wonderful. Tell him, Jean.
Well, I've been thinking...
I wish people would stop doing that.
And I decided I should come with you and Betty.
Jean!
I think the brandy and the cooking sherry cleared my brain for me.
Well, that's terrific. Is that all right with you, Betty? Jean coming with us?
Oh, of course. We'll show you.
Hang on.
Where does all this leave me? Facing a couple of charges of indecent behaviour.
Oh, just a second.
Now, if Jean's coming with us, you may as well join us as well, Vic.
What?
Yes, make up the foursome.
Of course, Celine.
Good old Vic.
Jean, look, if you're coming to Barcelona with us, you better wear a bra and pants. You can get changed in the car.
Oh, I had to see Bill before I leave. Ask him to put Pussy into quarantine.
Quarantine?
Yes, and then once we've settled in, he can arrange to fly the cat over to us. And then
no, hang on a second. Bill doesn't work for nothing, you know. We're going to have to leave him a few thousand for expenses, yeah.
Now, may I remind you that Mr. Perkins, alias Mr. Big, will be joining us any minute now.
Okay, let's get that fellow sorted out.
You lot really believe in fair shares fall, don't you?
Yes, we were just having a little...
I can see what the family was having, thank you.
Named in all?
Oh, God.
Well, you've bought the money again, have you?
I think you were living for Manchester.
Yes, we all thought that was the arrangement, Archie.
Well, the train doesn't leave till midnight, though, does it? Thought I'd come back and cheer the family up a bit.
Yes, well, we're all quite happy being miserable.
Oh, lucky I did return, though. There's been an accident outside your house.
An accident?
It's all in hand. Thank you, sir.
Apparently, you've run over a pedestrian.
What? A pedestrian?
It wasn't my fault.
That's what they all say.
Well, don't you think someone should send for an ambulance?
I have sent for an ambulance. It's a pity you and your family don't help a bit instead of indulging in your Australian fetishes.
You don't have to worry about the pedestrian. He's sitting on the pavement with his head in his hands.
Oh, dear.
It's all right. It's still on his shoulders.
Mr. Big turns up.
Yes. Oh, didn't I tell you? Mr. Big's already here.
Here?
Where? Outside.
Outside?
Yes. He's the injured pedestrian sitting on the pavement.
What?
Sergeant Slater has very kindly run over Mr. Big for him. Oh, he's sitting there mumbling, record, record,
record. Oh, my God.
Does he look dangerous?
Oh, not anymore. He's got double vision, he's got a sprained wrist and a broken ankle.
Wonderful.
And a fractured jaw.
That'll teach him for putting Mr. Nasty in the river.
That police car must have hit him pretty hard.
No, that only gave him the double vision. When I realised who he was, I gave him the fractured jaw, the sprained wrist and the broken ankle.
Well, I think that deserves another 5,000, Sergeant.
No, I've been thinking about that, Henry. I mean, you continually giving me these one-off settlements. Mm-hmm. Why not put me on the payroll permanently?
Payroll?
Yes, take me to Barcelona with you.
Barcelona?
You need looking after, Henry. There's a lot of villains knocking about out there.
There's quite a few in here as well.
It's not a bad idea, Henry. I mean, if people are going to put contracts on us.
But just a second, you're a serving police officer, aren't you?
I most certainly am.
Well, what's your superintendent going to say?
I think he'll be pleased to see me. He's been on the run in Spain for the last 6 months.
All right, you're on. Do you have a passport on you?
Don't be daft. I've got half a dozen other things.
All right, we better go out the back way before Sergeant Slater returns.
Yes,
come on.
Yes, please.
Oh, you've got to give Bill some money for Pussy.
Money for?
Don't even ask. We'll send Bill the money from Barcelona.
I'll just take this for the journey.
I'll take that. You take this.
Hey, do you think we can all squeeze into Mr. Brown's car?
Definitely. And just for the record, it's not Mr. Brown's car, it's my car, and it was bloody expensive.
Okay, then come on, Mr. Brown.
And as we're going to be living together, the name's Johnson, not Brown.
Got it, Percy.
And it's not Percy, it's Vic.
Okay, Adelaide.
It's not Adelaide, it's Betty.
Just whoa. You and your husband, you are Jean and Henry, aren't you?
Absolutely.
Oh, thank goodness for that.
Except for those who think we're Freddie and Genevieve, Archie.
Oh. Oh, and it's not Archie. It really is Sydney.
Oh. Mr. Perkins. Bill, you're supposed to be looking after our cat.
That's okay. He's in my taxi. It's Sergeant Slater I'm worried about.
What's he up to now?
He's not up to nothing. He got knocked down.
By your taxi?
No, by that pedestrian fella.
What?
Yeah. Sergeant Slater wanted to take his briefcase off him and he hit him on the side of the head with it.
What a nut cold.
God, bloody hell. You know what? I reckon then Mr. Roofkurs has got something illegal in his roofkurs.
And you know about Mr. Roofkurs and roofkurs.
Ah, come off it. I've heard enough in the last 2 hours to write a James Bond film.
Where's Mr. Roofkurs now?
Staggering up and down the road looking for number 42.
Oh my God.
We aren't back way, I reckon.
Oh, good thinking. Hang on, what do you mean by we?
Well, I'm coming with you.
Barcelona?
Why not? You're paying everybody else to keep their trap shut.
Well, we've already got a security guard.
Well, this is your lucky day. You've got yourself a gardener now, too.
That makes six of us.
Yeah, we might qualify for a good booking.
We're waiting for you in the side street.
All right, I'm just sorting out the terms of employment for the staff.
Sorting out? What? I've just been signed up as your new gardener.
I thought you were supposed to be looking after the cat.
Cat's okay. I'll drop her off with me sisters. And I'll meet you at British Airways check-in.
I hope you're as good at planning our garden.
I'll give the old girl 50 quid for her trouble, and you can add that to my first week's wages, plus 37 times 50, plus...
What's keeping everybody?
My money, by the looks of things.
Don't ask any questions. His sister's looking after the cat for 50 quid, and he's coming to Barcelona as our gardener.
I thought you were a married man, Bill.
Yes, I am, but she'll never think of looking for me in Barcelona.
Come on, then. The more the merrier.
Right, I'm parked up front. I better go that way.
You steer clear of Sergeant Slater.
And Mr. Broker.
See you at the airport.
We're all going to Sunnyside. Viva Spain.
We'll see you at the airport.
Now, Now, come on.
Yes, sir, I'm just making sure.
Brokos!
You'll have to speak clearer than that, sir.
Brokos, light me a boy, Jenny.
I'm afraid we don't speak your lingo.
Light me a boy, Jenny.
That sounds like Dutch.
Light me a boy, Jenny. Light me a boy, Jenny.
Well, that sounds like double Dutch. I think I'm beginning to get the lingo now.
I
didn't quite get that.
No, I'm going to get it. Give me the money.
Adi. Hang on. My wife's got the briefcase outside. Va. We'll send for an interpreter.
I don't need an interpreter.
Three.
We'll do a deal. 50-50.
To Divya.
We'll do a deal. Give him the lot.
Beer.
Oh, Beck! Oh, Jean, I think you've got a visitor.
You know who this is, don't you?
Oh, yes. Although I think he looks more like an effeminate teapot.
Then take it as if I'm God's sake.
Brokos.
He wants the Brokos.
Give it to him then, Jean.
Oh. Yeah,
what the heck is this?
Look out, it's loaded!
Bloody hell! Was it you fighting that gun? It
certainly was, and I think they got me a Kai pigeon too.
Can I open my eyes now?
What the hell is going on in there?
Coming, Sergeant.
Yeah, you're open.
Right. Oh, where's that fellow that hit me with the briefcase? Well, that's him. Oh, what the devil's happened to him?
Oh, he fell over.
What was all that shooting about? Who is this bloke?
I don't know.
Come on, who is he?
I suppose we better tell the truth.
What?
There's no need.
No, that the game's up. We've had a good run.
No,
we don't have to say anything.
No, I want to confess.
Don't say a word, Mr. Perkins.
No, it's better for all of us.
It's certainly not better
for
you.
I can do my own confession.
Shut up! Sit down. You, stand up. Okay, let's have it.
Yeah. I picked up this briefcase by mistake on the underground. The bloke who picked up my briefcase ended up in the river in Putney. The bloke who put him in the river in Putney ended up with a sprained wrist, a fractured jaw, and a broken ankle on my carpet. That briefcase, as you know, contains a few papers, cell phone, and what's left of a cheese and chutney sandwich. This briefcase contains £1,135,000, less 5% to him, and £25,000 to him, and £7,500 for a car worth £500. Right, that concludes the financial aspects of the matter. Now, on a personal front, she is not Adelaide the nudist, and he is not Percy the pervert. She is Betty, the good friend from Clapham, and he is Vic. Very plain and very simple, Vic. And this gentleman is not my brother Archie, reliable or otherwise, nor is he a travelling salesman hoping to catch the overnight train to Manchester. He's a part-time drinker in the Prince of Wales pub, where I was not soliciting men, nor do any of us indulge in hanky-panky under the blanket. He has a lot of faults, but he is who he says he is. I am not Freddie Perkins, this lady's brother-in-law. I am Henry Perkins, this lady's husband. This briefcase contains the goods that have caused all the trouble, and for which he was hoping to receive this. But when he received that, he turned up here demanding the return of his briefcase.
Say that again.
I picked up the
Sergeant, he was going to hand it back from the very beginning.
Vic.
It was a shock, you see.
Betty.
He's always been a bit simple-minded.
Jean.
Oi, Coke.
Coke? I couldn't drink another thing, honestly.
Cocaine.
Cocaine?
A briefcase full of pure cocaine. You'll get a sizable reward for this, Mr. Perkins.
Will I?
£3,000 at least.
Oh, yes, well, that'll repair the cuckoo clock anyway.
You're a credit to your community, Mr. Perkins.
Yes.
Okay, get him into the ambulance. You two, come on.
Yeah,
come on.
Ah! 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 Я буду вам за это.
Yeah, tell that to the judge.
You just look a little bit like an effeminate teapot, doesn't it?
That's it. Come on, Jean. Serve up the roast chicken for birthday boy.
Happy birthday, Henry.
Thanks,
yes.
Jean.
Happy birthday.
Thanks, Betty.
Happy birthday, Henry.
Thanks, Vic. Well done.
I just came back, Mr. Perkins, to say no hard feelings, eh?
Thank you, Sergeant. I'm sorry you missed out on early retirement.
Okay, let's go.
Go where?
Airport, Barcelona.
What? Phil, haven't you been listening? You've lost a lot. Sergeant Slater went off with all the cash.
Don't be daft. I transferred the money from the briefcase to the suitcase.
Hey!